time to check out what we've got loaded up. Let's open up the Project pane by clicking the tab at the top left or by hitting Command 1 if you're on a Mac. By default, the Project pane only shows the source and resources that are relevant to an Android build. That can be nice sometimes, but for now, let's use the dropdown at the top of this pane to open up the Project view. There we go, now we can see all the files and directories in our project directory. Let's open up the settings.gradle file. This shows us all the modules that make up this project. Looks like this build has desktop, Android, iOS, and HTML modules. So that's where the code for each of those specific platforms lives. Then there's also the core module. That's where we'll write the code that will run everywhere. Not all of these files and folders will be super relevant to you, but I want to go over what all of them do just so that there's nothing that seems magical in here. First, the .gradle folder. Gradle is a very smart build tool, and when you ask it to compile something, it checks to see if it's already compiled that file, and if so, it says that that compilation task is up to date and skips it. The .gradle folder is where Gradle caches that sort of information. The .idea folder is where Android Studio holds its information about the project and the state of the workspace. It's just a ton of complicated XML you don't need to touch. We already talked about the Android, Core, Desktop, HTML, and iOS folders. Then there's the Gradle folder. The Gradle folder works together with the GradleW and GradleWBAT files to form what's called the Gradle Wrapper. Basically, the point is that Gradle knows how to download itself, so you can version control what version of your build tools you're actually building the project with. It's something super fancy you don't need to touch, but it's also why you didn't have to install Gradle in order to build this project. Pretty cool, right? The Git Ignore file tells Git which of these files shouldn't be checked into version control. These consist mostly of files that are user-specific settings, like everything in the .idea folder, and of build outputs, like everything that's in each of the build folders, where Gradle spits out its outputs. Gradle.properties and local.properties store more Gradle-specific configuration. Finally, there's a README file that explains all this in much more detail. So that's it. That's all the files in a LibGDX project. Nothing really magical.